And good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome here as we get ready for chase race number 5 of the 3rd season of the NSRA Hershey's Cup Series. We're getting ready to go road course racing at one of my favorite road courses on the circuit. This is Lime Rock Raceway in Lime Rock, Connecticut. And I'll tell you what, folks, if you enjoyed yesterday's race in the Almond Joy Series, you're going to really love today's race. I mean, last week we said, yeah, more than likely Oswego's going to be a wild card race. It's going to be unpredictable. Yeah, maybe our elimination races in Joltis is going to be a wild card race. It's going to be unpredictable. Well, let me tell you what, folks. The meat in the sandwich is Lime Rock, and it's going to be just as much of a wild card race as Oswego was, and I'm sure Zenjoltis is going to be, because here today in the Hershey's Cup Series race, they're going to run 35 laps, no cautions to bunch them back up. It's basically whatever you got at the end is what you've got. You got to hope it has you in position to be inside the top 8 in the point standings heading into next week at Zenjoltis. We'll give you the point stands and everything, how it all looks, that we're going to be keeping an eye on during the course of the day. But on the front row, holding the pole position, Charles Sanfer, 3-time winner last season, still looking for his first win this season. Alongside of him, the highest starting chaser, Cole Baker, in the 18. Cole Baker comes into today's race, as I'm waiting for my standings to load up here. But for the moment, we'll go down and we'll get the command to fire up the engines while we're waiting.
Drivers, start them engines!
And there's the command to fire them up. Cole Baker comes into this race third in the point stands. He's actually only 4 points out of the points lead at this current point in time as well. And that was weird. We got some issue going on with both Richardson and there was somebody else. Was that McIntyre? What was that? Did they not get started? Chris Dodd and James Richardson, something happened to both of them. They couldn't get their cars fired. Well, that was weird. There's Richardson. I guess they're servicing his car now. I think he might be able to get back out in time to take the green. If he's lucky. Yeah, he's going to get back out. Boy, that's a lucky break for Richardson. That's a chase driver there in James Richardson, the 11, who comes into this race 7th in the point standings. But your points coming into this race for your chase points, and the 12 drivers still remain in the chase for the championship are as follows. Michael Norman is the current points leader. Dylan Poteet is second. He's 2 points back. Cole Baker is third, 4 points back. Then Emmanuel Hartnett and Jake Baskinger. That's your top 5. 6th in points is Cat Tellier. 7th is James Richardson. And there's actually a tie for 8th, which is the cutoff line. Matt Haas and Cody Lamas. However, since Matt Haas has 3 wins, Cody Lamas only has 1. Matt Haas is technically 8th. And the 4 drivers right now that come into today's race outside of the... What in the world are they doing here? Okay. Not sure what they're doing here at the front of the field. But anyway, the 4 drivers that come into this race in the 4 current elimination spots would be Cody Lamas, Trent Dunham, Blaine Keyes, and Kyle Matthews. However, Kyle Matthews, who is right now 12th of the drivers. Is Sanford going to be coming to pit road? I don't know what the case is here. Anyway, 12th in the stands, Kyle Matthews is only 11 points back from the cutoff line. So I think Cole Baker might be coming to pit road, actually. Somebody's coming to pit road. It's either the 18 or the 03, and I think it's Baker's going to be coming to pit lane, which, in all honesty, might be the safest part on the racetrack right at the moment, but, yeah, Baker's going to come into the pit lane. So Richardson already was on pit road. Baker's now coming to pit road. I don't understand what's going on here with these drivers here before even taking the green flag, but whatever the case, yeah, Chris Dodd hasn't even left pit lane yet. Whatever the case, though, we're ready to turn him loose. 35 laps of racing. Green flag is out, and there's another chaser on pit road. That's the 78 of Matt Haas. What the heck is going on here? We had Richardson and Chris Dodd not even able to get going at the start of this race. And now we got Matt Haas on pit road. Cole Baker came to pit road. We'll do our best to try and update you on everything that happens here on the racetrack. We don't have any replays we can go back and look at due to the fact that we're going green the whole way. And Emmanuel Hartnett's already encountered problems. He got spun into the catch fence. That's a chase driver. So 4 chasers already, and we haven't even completed lap 1, have run into some kind of issue here already at Lime Rock. Well, this doesn't look good back here. They're 3 wide. Trent Dunham, Zach Flickinger. John Archer's turn, Zach Flickinger. And Dallas McIntosh gets jacked up. Fitzwater gets involved. Flickinger going to be able to get the car back going, it looks like. Anthony McCrory has just gotten wrecked there in the bootleg, dog leg, whatever you want to call it. Cole Baker coming back onto the racetrack. There's Kyle Matthews, came in an elimination spot right now. He's battling with Chloe Erickson for the seventh position. Is Dylan Poteet there, Michael Norman there. Cole Baker returning back to the racetrack. I think he's now trapped a lap down, so he's just got to hope that more drivers encounter problems here, so he'll have a bit of a cushion heading into next week. It's then Joltas as Keith Batson is off the track. Oh, this is where the trouble spot, I think, is going to be on the racetrack right now. Oh, Johnny Gardner, William Duncan, they're rubbing doors. Looks like they all get through it pretty well. Charles Samper, though, enjoying the view out in front. Cat Tellier on pit road. Emmanuel Hart now on pit road. That's two chase drivers right there. As Samper going to go out in front. Joseph Srigley right now is in second. That's Joshua Sakuli trying to hold off a hard-charging JT Bryant and his teammate Dylan Young. Kyle Matthews right now the highest running chaser. He is currently situated in the sixth position. Chloe Erickson seventh. Dylan Poteet right now runs in eighth. And then you got Jake Baskinger there in ninth. So right now it's looking like Norman, Poteet, and Baskinger in good shape if they continue to run where they're at heading into next weekend's Zen Joltis. But Charles Samper out in front. Track position we saw in the Omnitrix Series race is a key thing. And Charles Samper with starting on the pole, we can see he's been able to keep everyone else at bay. Cat Tellier are going to try and salvage what she can. She's returning back to the racetrack. I'm not sure if Emmanuel Hartnett's going to be able to do the same. I think he just actually retired from this race. James Richardson's got damage on his 11. We're going to have to update where all of our chase drivers are at some point here. Drivers that are out of the race up to this point are Anthony McCurry and Emmanuel Hartnett. And then three chasers, Cole Baker, Matt Haas, and Cat Tellier are all trapped a lap down. 37 cars still running on the lead lap, but we've only completed three of our 35 laps here today. Field getting spread out. Maybe we'll... Oh, wait a minute. There's another car in trouble there. I think that's rookie Cody Hagan. He's blown up. I was going to say, with them getting spread out, maybe we'll end up not having as much issues on the track, but nope, not the case. Cody Hagan there, go or go home non-chartered driver. In trouble, Brandon Gonzalez just went off course. Comes back on the track right in front of James Richardson. Just gotta hope these drivers start spreading out a little. That's when we can start to focus on the battling on the racetrack instead of looking, trying to see who's encountered problems. There's Michael Norman. He's right now running in 11th, and a couple of spots behind him in 13th and 14th are the Sega Motorsports cars of Blaine Keyes and Trent Dunham, who both came into this race outside of the top eight. Well, right now, with trouble that's being had by Cat Tellier, James Richardson, Matt Haas, Emmanuel Hartnett, these two right now in good position to move back into the top eight and maybe be able to move on to the round of eight after the checkered flag waves next week at Zen Joltis. Meanwhile, up in front, it is still Charles Samper. Joseph Srigley runs in second. And then it's Fords, 3, 4, 5, and 6. As I look right now, four of our top five have not been to Victory Lane yet this season. Samper, Srigley, Sakuli, and Dylan Young. I don't know if anybody knows, but I've been having external hard drive issues where I'm trying to recover files, so I am not able to actually look back and see who won at certain races. So if I'm incorrect, I apologize in my information. Charles Samper, I believe, though, his last win came last season at Talladega Super Speedway, next to last race of that season two. Joseph Srigley, I'm trying to remember if he has a victory. He might, but I cannot seem to be able to pull it in if he does have one, so I do apologize for that. Joshua Sakuli, I think his last win came in season two, but I don't recall where it was. I know he won at Martinsville, but he also won another race that season as well. JT Bryant, of course, the only driver inside the top five that does have a win this season. That, of course, came at Arizona. And Dylan Young hasn't won since last season at Homestead Miami Speedway. But right now, Charles Samper with just about a second over Joseph Swrigley. Let's take an update where everybody is running. It looks like Cody Hagan is now out of the race as well, so three drivers out of the race. Let's update where all your chase drivers currently are situated after the completion of lap 6 onto lap 7. Highest running chaser still is Kyle Matthews. Dylan Pote behind him. Matthews in 6th, Pote in 8th. Jake Baskinger runs in 9th, so three chasers right now in the top 10. Michael Norman runs in 11th, Blaine Keyes in 13th, Trent Dunham in 14th place. And you got to go a long ways down before you end up finding everybody else, which includes, wow, you have to go a long way down. Cole Baker, a lap down there in 36th. James Richardson, 34th, just barely on the lead lap. Matt Haas, a lap down in 37th. Cody Lamas is also a lap down now in the 48th and 38th. And Cat Tellier, a lap down in 39th. And out of the race, Emmanuel Hartnett. That's where your chase drivers are running. So right now, as things are situated with where Michael Norman, Jake Baskinger, and Dylan Poteet are running, they could head into next week at St. Joltis, mathematically already locked into the round of 8. Drivers this is going to probably hurt the most, I would think, would be Tellier, Richardson, Haas, and Lamas. And the reason I say those and not Emmanuel Hartnett, even though Hartnett is the only chase driver currently out of this event, is because Emmanuel Hartnett came into today's race 12 points above the cut line, as opposed to Cat Tellier coming in merely 4 points above the cut line, James Richardson merely 2 points above the cut line. So a little bit of a real estate, little bit of cushion for Emmanuel Hartnett to kind of afford a bad race here at Lime Rock. But in the end, the point standings will tell the story. We got the battle here for third between a couple of Fords. JT Bryant trying to get around Joshua Sakuli. And I ended up noticing on the scoring monitor, you know, we saw all these drivers having difficulties being on pit road. Well, Chris Dodd, there he is behind Benjamin Miles. And if you look at the ticker, Chris Dodd is right now scored in the 17th position. So he did get back out on the lead lap, and he is still running inside the top 20. So nice job by that 88 team to get him out there. Other drivers that came to pit road have found themselves now a lap down, like Cole Baker and Matt Haas. That's the other car I was trying to remember. There's Cole Baker right there. Baker in the 18, I believe, right now is the first car one lap down. He's in the 33rd position, as a couple more drivers have fallen off the lead lap, including Joshua Michaels, Andrew Davis, and Kev Shearer. So Cole Baker actually moves up now to the 33rd position because of that. Baker just hoping that he can survive and that more drivers encounter problems, because every position counts. And Baker, as I said, came into this race inside the top 3 in the standings. Dylan Pote came in 2nd in points. There he is, trying to fill the gap that Cole Baker was making, getting by rookie Chloe Erickson. Pote got another chaser behind him, and Kyle Matthews currently in 8th, and then another chaser in Baskinger currently in 9th. Bryant moves into 3rd. Swrigley has not been able to get to Charles Sanford's back bumper, but he's at least closing up ground and at least keeping Charles Sanford within striking distance. Let's look at the tail end of the field here. There's Michaels, who's now a lap down to the race leaders. Andrew Davis also a lap down. James Richardson right now, I believe, just picked up a spot on Zach Flickinger and one on Brandon Gonzalez. So now the 11 is up to the 30th position. Whoa, went off the track there, though. Got off course, and that allows Brandon Gonzalez to get a run on him. Got some front-end damage there on Sean Galligan as well as William Duncan. Oh, this is close back here with Daniel Olsen, Jessica Shelton. The hard part of the racetrack where drivers have difficulty not rubbing doors with each other, and that usually messes up their corners. Looks like they're all getting through it okay right now, though. Lane Keyes has got some damage. A little bit of rear-end damage on the 8. He was running up inside the top 15, and now he's dropped back to the 23rd position as the U.S. Army Chevrolet. You can see some right side and rear damage on his machine. And he needs to get himself a good run here today, because he comes into this race 11th of the 12 chase drivers. There's Cody Lamas. He's now a lap down, having to come to pit road for a guess repairing damage, and he's currently 36. Not good for him as well, as he came in one of the drivers outside of the top eight. Whoa, Nathan Hudson! He lost it, and then he was able to gather it back up. Nice save by the six, but he lost some spots as a result. And there's a slow car there. That's Benjamin Miles. There's Trent Dunham, trying to get himself back up into the top eight in the standings. Had a solid round one of the chase. A little bit of a rocky start to round two, but at the moment, Trent is currently situated in the 14th position. And that puts him right now ahead of drivers like Cody Lamas, Matt Haas, James Richardson, Cat Tellier. So he could be up as high as sixth, maybe fifth in the standings with where he's running right now. Don't have live standings, unfortunately, but that's where I would calculate him. That's where I would project him at this current point in time in relation to where everybody else is running. Michael Norman, though, we talked about Trent Dunham having a good round one. Well, Michael Norman had a good round one as well. He was the points leader when we finished out the first round at Indianapolis, and he's having a solid round two as well. Michael Norman's maybe been one of the most consistent drivers since this chase began. Comes into this first race of the second round as the points leader, and right now solidly running in the 12th position. May have a shot at the top 10 as they're battling for that 10th position just ahead of him. Levi McIntyre has it. Tim Walsh wants it. Joseph Strigley has reeled Charles Sanfer in. Well, he was about 7/10 of a second behind Charles that last lap. Looks like he might have lost a little bit of ground in the first few corners to the Valvoline Chevrolet this time. I know last season at least all three of the Retro Racing Enterprises cars went to victory lane. I can't remember if they all did in season one or not. They might have, but I kind of feel that they didn't. But regardless, we do know that all three drivers went to victory lane last season. Well, this season, two of them have found victory lane. Jessica Shelton at Daytona, Kyle Matthews back at, I think it was Rockingham, UK. And he also had another win, and I can't remember where it was at. But Charles Sanfer is the lone driver out of Retro Racing Enterprises that has not yet gone to victory lane. He was a three-time winner last season, and he would love to be able to pick up the victory here, his first win of the season in season three, and make it two seasons in a row that it's been a sweep that all the Retro Racing Enterprises drivers have found victory lane. Now, we saw yesterday in the Almond Joy Series race, Richard Johnson started on the pole. He did drop back to as far as third place, but fought his way back up and was able to go coast to coast, starting on the pole and winning the race. Charles Sanfer, however, has yet to encounter a challenge for his race lead. Joseph Strigley, though, like I said, he's kept him within striking distance. JT Bryant almost 3.5 seconds back, just riding for the moment. Let's also keep in mind, too, that we only ran, I think it was 25 laps in our Almond Joy Series race. They didn't have to pit, even though we had a caution flags. So they might have been able to save under those yellow flags. There were like 3 or 4 cautions in our Almond Joy Series race here yesterday. There's no cautions here today. So they're basically using up fuel, not being able to really save a whole lot, which makes me wonder, with 10 laps added on to this race, these drivers potentially might have to come to pit road and make green flag pit stops. I'll tell you what, Joseph Strigley got a nice second half of that course right there, and he now is on the back bumper of Charles Sanfer. We may have ourselves a battle for the lead here within the next couple of laps. The tough part for Joseph Strigley, though, is he's the driver that has to be on the attack. Charles Sanfer is able to take whichever line he wants, the line that best suits him. Joseph Strigley's job is to try and go where Charles Sanfer isn't, and that might not suit well for that 24 car. It's the one tough thing about road courses. Looks like Sanfer got through the bus stop a little bit better than Strigley, but Strigley's still within closing distance. And speaking of closing distance, these drivers, if they continue on with this pace, they're going to be starting to encounter traffic momentarily. I just saw, not too far ahead, There you see, heading into turn one, the 35 of Cat Tellier, who is off the lead lap. Cat Tellier damaged off the pace, and they are going to catch Cat Tellier maybe within the next two or three laps. And that could play a factor into when Joseph Srigley decides to start challenging Charles Samfer for the race lead. Right now, though, gotta tip your hat to one Kyle Matthews running solidly at the moment in the seventh position. He's got Dylan Poteet, though, trying to take that spot from him. Kyle Matthews is exactly the run he needs. Came in 12th of the 12 chase drivers still in the hunt for this championship. And this is exactly the kind of run that Kyle Matthews needs to have to get himself back up into the top eight in the standings. Saw right there, Dylan Poteet kind of back off. I think Poteet kind of realized that Kyle Matthews, the position he's in, he needs to have every position he can. And we got pit stops. And the reason that I'm saying that I think Poteet backed off, Poteet came into this race second in the point standing, so he just needs a solid run. And I don't think he's willing to force the issue with a driver who's desperately trying to get out of the danger zone and back up into the top eight. Levi McIntyre was just on pit lane, as was Dallas McIntosh, our winner last week at Oswego. Sean Galligan also on the pit lane. So the cycle of green flag pit stops begin. Blaine Keyes now on the pit road. And William Duncan's coming as well. So now the question is, when do the leaders come to pit lane? And according to my calculations, this will be the only pit stop they'd have to make. Samfer's not coming in, neither is Srigley. Bryant stays out. Dylan Young got around Joshua Cicculli for the fourth position. Looks like Cicculli might have given up that spot willingly because he's coming onto pit road this time. Here comes Jake Baskinger. Baskinger from the ninth position. Looks like Leon Alvarez may be signaling he's coming to pit road. No, he's not. Actually, Carson Scott is, though. Here comes Johnny Gardner. And everybody else is not going to come to pit road. Oh, Srigley got around Samfer. Joseph Srigley, we didn't even see the battle for the lead. And Joseph Srigley has managed to get around Charles Samfer for the race lead. So that's our first lead change of the day. It happens here on lap number 20. And now Joseph Srigley, just after passing Charles Samfer, he's going to come to pit road. Now the question is he going to lead this lap? Bryanson. Dylan Young, Chloe Erickson, Matthews is coming in, Poteet's coming in. Nobody's going to stay out and try and lead that lap. Here comes Norman, Arndt, might be Chris Dodd. Chris Dodd might be the leader. Yeah, he's going to be the leader. He didn't lead that lap, though. Chris Dodd's going to be the race leader. He stays out an extra lap. And I wasn't sure, I'd have to see the scoring monitor, but it looked like a couple of go-or-go-home non-charter drivers are actually having a really decent day here right now. Running up inside the top 15, one looked like it might have been Johnny Gardner, and the other being Chris Dollerton. We're going to have to wait till the green flag pit stop cycle around, though, to find out indeed where these drivers are situated. As I believe Chris Dodd is the leader, and I believe he is the only driver yet to come to pit road. He might be able to stay out another lap here. Nope, but he's going to come to pit road this time. Now, probably the reason Chris Dodd was able to stay out that extra lap was because he ended up not being able to get his car fired at the start. He was on pit road. They serviced his race car. He came back out on the racetrack, still on the lead lap. And so he was about a half lap, maybe a full lap to the good on everybody else. Question is, though, will he lead this lap, or will Joseph Srigley get around here quickly enough to be able to beat him to the line? Yes, Srigley is still the race leader. He was able to get out ahead of Charles Samfer off pit road, and Chris Dodd will not even lead this lap. Srigley back to the top of the leaderboard. Well, Chris Dodd tried it, tried to get the bonus point, but he's not going to be able to do it. Srigley thwarts him both times. We'll wait till they get around across the line this next time by before we give you the full field running order, but Joseph Srigley has managed just before green flag pit stops to get around Charles Samfer, and now he is showing the way here at Lime Rock. And we are nearing the 10 laps to go mark. Let me just quickly check and make sure nobody else is retired from the race. Oh, we do have one more driver out of the race now. That being Nathan Hudson in the 6. So Hudson, Hagen, McCrory, and Hartnett all out of the race. And our scoring monitor says we have 33 drivers still on the lead lap of the drivers still running. So Wrigley going to cross the line. And now we can give you your full field rundown. As they cross, Joseph Swrigley showing the way, trying to pick up what would be the third win of the season for Swrigley Motorsports. Emmanuel Hartnett going to victory lane at Eldora. Kev Shearer going to victory lane at Indianapolis. Charles Stamfer led the first half of this race and now finds himself back in second. Third place is Joshua Sekulli. Fourth place, JT Bryant, and Dylan Young completes your top five. Chloe Erickson, solid outing for the rookie there in sixth position. Kyle Matthews is the highest running chaser. He's still in seventh. Dylan Pote still runs in eighth. Tim Walsh is in ninth. And the points leader, Michael Norman, has, I believe, now cracked the top 10. No, he has not. Actually, I think 10th place might be Chris Dollerton. He is. Chris Dollerton is now in 10th. Nice run for the number 12 Honda out of Rage Motorsports. 11th place then would be Chris Dodd. Oh, and Jake Baskinger, who is right now running in the, I think, the 12th position. He's got damage. Did he wreck with Michael Norman? Where's the 3? Oh no! Johnny Gardner and Levi McIntyre have just wrecked there in the bus stop. And Norman's on pit road. I think he and Baskinger just wrecked with each other. That's two chasers that came into this race in the top 5 in the standings. And oh boy, I mean, good grief. We thought that this was gonna be a point shakeup at the first half of this race. It's gonna be a point shakeup now. Two more chasers involved here. Michael Norman, who came in the points leader. Jake Baskinger, who came in 5th. Well, we gave you Chris Dollerton in 10th. Let's give you the rest of the full field rundown as they are right now. 11th would be Chris Dodd. 12th now is Trent Dunham because of all that. 13th is John Arndt. 14th place is, they're saying, Benjamin Miles. 15th is Brandon Gonzalez. 16th place is Blaine Keyes. By the way, Jake Baskinger just retired out of the race. He was scored in 17th. That's now going to be Zach Flickinger in 17th. 18th, Daniel Olson. 19th, Jessica Shelton. 20th is going to be Keith Batson. 21st is under contest. James Richardson wants it. Leon Alvarez has it, so that's 21st and 22nd. William Duncan is 23rd, and 24th is Sean Galligan. 25th place is Joshua Michaels, and I believe he just became the first car one lap down. All these drivers ahead of Joseph Swrigley are on the tail end of the lead lap. Cars that are a lap down, now Joshua Michaels, Matt Haas, Andrew Davis, Kev Shearer, Dallas McIntosh, Cody Lamas, Cole Baker. Cat Tellier is 4 laps down in the 38th position, but we have 5 more drivers that just retired from the race, make it 6. Baskinger, Norman, Fitzwater, Levi McIntyre, Carson Scott, and Johnny Gardner all out of the race now. So we have less than 10 laps to go. So that means that 3 chasers are going to be behind the wall. Those 3 chasers came into this race 1st, 4th, and 5th in the point standings. Talk about Zenjoltis being a wild card race. We told you Lime Rock was going to be just as much of one, and it is definitely living up to that reputation. This could get interesting here at the finish, though. Joseph Swrigley is about to encounter about 4 or 5 drivers on the tail end of the lead lap, including Galligan, William Duncan, Leon Alvarez, and James Richardson. The question is he going to be able to dispose of them pretty quickly? Because if he's not able to, that could bring Charles Stamfer, even Joshua Sekulli, right up into the mix for this win. It's really through the bus stop. You can see up ahead, the first car he would encounter would be our Daytona 500 winner, Sean Galligan. Charles Stamfer may actually have a battle for his second spot. Well, thought he was going to. Sekulli was there and then lost ground exiting the bus stop. Now Stamfer firmly back in control of second place. And here comes Swrigley. Swrigley going to the inside first on William Duncan. putting Duncan down a lap. And on the plus side for Swigley, the more cars he passes, the more pressure he puts on Charles Samper, having to deal with lap traffic instead of getting to his back bumper and battling him for the race lead, potentially the win. Swigley's got to be careful, though, here in the middle of this traffic. Can't afford to make a mistake. Right now, the drivers that stand to have really solid points days as far as chase drivers are concerned are Kyle Matthews and Dylan Poteet. And I guess you could also throw Trent Dunham into that mix as well. Blaine Keyes, the issues that other chasers have had, he's 16th, so we'll have to see where this situates him heading into next week at Zendjoltis. James Richardson just trying to pick up spots, he's 21st. And Cole Baker and Matt Haas, Cody Lamas all been trying to pick up spots as they were trapped a lap down very early in this thing. Haas 25th, Lamas 27th, and Baker in 29th. The good news for Baker, though, is that drivers that were around him in the point standings, like Norman, Hartnett, and Baskinger, have all encountered problems as well. So Cole Baker, despite the fact that he's not running that well here today, he may still end up heading into Zendjoltis in a pretty good spot and a pretty good position of being able to make the round of eight. Joseph Swigley now has two lap machines between himself and Charles Samper, Sean Galligan and William Duncan, separating the 24 from the 03. Samper not able to yet get around William Duncan, so that is really playing out well into the hand of the driver of the Pepsi Exalta Chevrolet. As he hits the line, we have six laps to go here at Lime Rock. Samper's got to start working this lap traffic, or else if he doesn't, if he keeps getting bunched up behind them, there's no way he's going to have time to be able to get up to Swigley's back bumper and challenge for this lead. As a matter of fact, Samper may have worse problems. The problems he's having getting around the lap traffic is actually bringing Joshua Sakuli and JT Bryant into the picture. Samper may end up not even finishing this race in second if he's not able to dispose of William Duncan and Sean Galligan in very quick and orderly fashion. Samper seems very tentative, trying to make a move here on William Duncan. The bad news for him is Joseph Swigley right now has a bit of clean racetrack before he gets to the next driver. That is Leon Alvarez, who is up to speed. Then you got James Richardson up ahead as well. Five laps to go. These laps taken away are not Sanford's best friend. And look at there, Sanford, desperation move. He almost looked like he was going to go three wide there with William Duncan when Duncan stepped out of line on Sean Galligan. But it looks like Samper going to go to the inside of William Duncan. Now swings around the outside, trying to take that and get by the 60. Then he'll set his sights on the 44 of Galligan, which he may try doing into this corner. Nope, not quite. Samper, however, looks like he may be able to get by William Duncan going through the bus stop. And then he's got to try and get by Sean Galligan. Look at Joshua Sakuli and JT Bryant now getting into the mix. A little contact there between the 73 and the 22. And they made more contact. Then it was Sakuli nearly pushing JT Bryant off course, heading into the bus stop. Beating and bagging and rubbing doors there for that third position. Samper has now cleared William Duncan. Oh, we had some smoke up here. Somebody just spin? Might have been James Richardson. Richardson might have just spun out. That was right in front of the race leader, Joseph Swigley. Oh yeah, there's a lot of damage there on the 11 car now. He just spun out, it appears. Swigley got through it though. Now that's another machine that Charles Samper has to get by before he can get up to Sean Galligan, before he can get up to Joseph Swigley. I think it's all but over right now unless Swigley makes a major, major mistake and Samper is able to capitalize, because right now there are two lap cars, both pretty badly damaged and somewhat off the pace, and Joseph Swigley has a lot of clean racetrack before he gets to Leon Alvarez. So, yeah, I think the only person right now that can mess this up for Joseph Swigley is Joseph Swigley. We'll look and see if anybody else is retired late in this race. Nope, still the same drivers that we already knew. Baskinger, Norman, Fitzwater, McIntyre, Carson Scott, Johnny Gardner, Nathan Hudson, Cody Hagan, Anthony McCurry, and Emmanuel Hartnett. And we have 21 cars still on the lead lap. Leon Alvarez just ahead of Joseph Swigley. He has scored the last car on the lead lap. This, they're battling between Richardson and Galligan. I don't know if that's necessarily for position. That is actually, that's for the 22nd spot. And for Richardson, every position counts. Richardson coming into this race, 7th in the point standings, a mere 2 points above the cut line. So Richardson just trying to get every spot available. Not bad after spinning out here in this turn a couple of laps ago. Swrigley, though, it will be 2 laps to go this time. Joseph Swrigley making the move at just the right time, just before the cycle of green flag pit stops. He's able to get by Charles Sanford and then held the spot, leaving pit road. Joseph Swrigley right now en route to picking up his first win of season 3. And I noticed a driver that's popped up even higher in the top 10. He's actually trying to get a top 6 here. That is go or go home driver Chris Dollerton. What a run he is having here today. Running right behind Kyle Matthews, who really needed this kind of a run as well. Solid outing for the 09. And you know that as much as Chris Dollerton wants to have that 6th finishing position, Kyle Matthews wants it even more. Dylan Poteet, I think he'll head into Zenjoltis as the overall points leader in the chase, as he's had a solid outing in the 8th position. Nice job there by Chloe Erickson. That rookie's taken to this series very nicely, running in 9th place. And there is Trent Dunham, who, like Kyle Matthews, may find himself back in the top 8 in the standings right now, scored in the 12th position. For Blaine Keyes, there he is. Blaine Keyes currently scored in 16th. Don't know if he'd move back up into the top 8 or not, but the white flag was just displayed, so let's head back up to the race leader and more than likely race winner of this event, Joseph Swrigley. Down through the final corner into the right-hander, Joseph Swrigley. His first win of season 3 comes at the road course of Lime Rock, takes the checkered flag here today. Joseph Swrigley is your winner in chase race number 5. First win of season 3 for Joseph Swrigley. Third win of the season for Swrigley Motorsports, as I mentioned. Hartnett and Kev Shearer already finding victory lane here this season. And if I'm not mistaken, I believe that means that only one driver remains to go to victory lane for the team, and I think that would be another go-or-go-home non-charter driver in Jonathan Zorlin. So if Zorlin ends up making a race in the upcoming weeks, watch out. Don't know if the standings will be official yet. They may wait until Leon Albrecht in 21st place in the tail end lead lap crosses the line, but we will step out regardless and wait for the standings to become official. Yeah, they're waiting for Albrecht to cross the line, which he is about to do right now. It looks like Brandon Gonzalez had to come to pit road at the last lap, and that's going to cost him a good finish. He'll finish 21st. So that's going to do it. Standings are indeed now official. So Joseph Swrigley officially is your winner. Charles Sanford, so close. He's been close a couple of times in the last few weeks of picking up his first victory of the season, but today it ends up being Joseph Swrigley who denies him a chance. As Swrigley wins Sanford second. JT Bryant, Joshua Cooley, and Dylan Young, those Fords ran third, fourth, and fifth for most of this race. Solid, solid runs for all three of them. Kyle Matthews is the highest finishing chaser in 6th, so we'll have to see where this positions him heading to next week at Zenjoltis. No doubt it's going to put him up inside the top 8. Chris Dollerton is the highest finishing go or go home non-charter driver in 7th place. Great run for him. And Dylan Poteet will take the points lead over from Michael Norman heading to Zenjoltis. And with this run and the trouble that a lot of other drivers had, Dylan Poteet may head into Zenjoltis completely worry-free, and he may automatically move into the round of 8, regardless of what happens next week at Zenjoltis. We'll have to see what the mathematicians come up with when we finish out here today at Lime Rock. Chloe Erickson, great run for that rookie, a solid top 10 in 9th. And Tim Walsh, great run there for Tim Walsh in that 10th position a couple weeks after being eliminated from the chase for the championship. Chris Dodd, talk about turning a bad day into something good. Chris Dodd actually didn't even get the car fired up at the start of this race, had to come to pit road, was able to get back onto the racetrack without going a lap down, and managed to finish in 11th. Trent Dunham may join Kyle Matthews back up in the top 8 in the standings. He gets 12th here today. Let's find out where the rest of your chasers finish. Blaine Keyes finishes in the 16th position. Blaine Keyes came in 11th in the point standings of the 12 Chase drivers, so we'll have to see if this puts him back up inside the top eight. James Richardson fighting and scrapping for every position he could. He manages to finish the first car lap down in 22nd. We'll have to see if that keeps him in the top eight or not. Matt Haas also finishing a lap down. He managed to finish in 25th. Cody Lamas finished in 27th, and Cole Baker finished in 28th. We'll have to see if any of those drivers are up inside the top eight after this. But then here's the big story. Take a look at these chasers. Four laps down, 32nd, Cat Tellier. Out of the race, chaser Jake Baskinger. Michael Norman came in the points leader. He finishes out of the race in 34th. And Emmanuel Hartnett finishes dead last here today in the 42nd position. So I'll tell you what, I can't even in my head try and work out the figures of trying to figure out who now is down in the basement in 9th through 12th and who is up inside the top 8 in the standings right now. We're going to have to wait and find out same time that you guys do. But thank you all so much for tuning in today's race from Lime Rock. If you enjoyed it, be sure to give this video a like, subscribe, become part of the crew today. We've shown you your full finish results. Congratulations to Joseph Strigley once again on the win here today at Lime Rock. Next week, we whittle it down from 12 chase drivers to 8 chase drivers to begin the third round of the chase for the championship. Who's going to be in the Elite 8? Can't wait to find out. Hope you guys can't wait as well. Up next, it's going to be, as I said, Zen Joltis, Almond Joy, and Hershey's Cup Series action going to be coming to you from that Mega Super Speedway. So up next are your rookie points, your overall points, and your championship points heading into next week as you've been watching a production of the NCRA, offline racing at its best. So long from Lime Rock.